question. Have you ever watched so much television that you forget that you are actually a real person and that, like, you live in the real world? You know what I mean? Well, my personal favourite is when you're, like, lying on your laptop and it dies and you're, like, confronted with what you've become on the black screen, like, it's, like, mirroring. Sidetrack. There's so much good stuff out at the moment. Season 2 of Love. Season 5 of Homeland. This American Life. The 100. Amazing. Transparent. Gotten Paige onto that. If you've watched any of those, comment down below. I've been watching too much TV at the moment, so I've decided that I need to think for myself. I've decided to make a video about having a positive outlook, a positive spin on being stuck here in this hospital. So I will be giving you 13 reasons why being stuck in this hospital bed ain't so bad. Number one, believe it or not, but this place actually isn't party central. There are no bongos at 4 a.m. There's no such thing as Tequila Tuesday. I don't have to wear headphones to sleep unless Mavis is snoring from the room next to me. Mavis, if you're watching, if Mavis has a YouTube channel, bless. No, but it's great. It's silent. Number two, I get to wear pajamas all the time. And I don't have to hawk eye, like watch all my clothes being washed in the washing machine, just in case Antonio from Italy takes a shining to Tyler's hoodie. Number three, I get to eat all the custard and jelly I want. And I have a little bell to summon the nurse to get me more. The power's going to my head. Number four, I don't have to label my food. So dirty backpackers don't eat my food. Gone are the days of me making kind but firm messages to stick on my food. Like, Pipers, please don't eat. And when that inevitably doesn't work, leaving passive aggressive notes like, don't kill my mood by eating my food. If you eat my bread, I will hit you on the head. If you eat my grub, you are a scrub. Hyphen. You are a scrubber. Doesn't have to rhyme. It's ideal if it does, but as long as it gets the message across. Number five. It's very unlikely that my sister will make trippy tea here. Unless she goes into Mavis's bedroom. I'm kidding. Number six. It's safe. It's pretty safe here. I mean, I was living on a mezzanine with no walls or a door, so anyone could come in and go through my stuff. So yeah, that's a perk. Number six, no one can go through my stuff here. Number seven, my mum can visit me here. And Dad, haven't seen you. You haven't been visiting me between the scheduled regulated visiting hours of 8 to 10 and 2 to 4. How's Queensland? Hope you have a really nice tan. Number eight, my friends can come and visit me now because they were also banned from coming to visit me because of the whole tea thing, which wasn't my fault. And being in here is just annoying. Like, it's just, you know what I mean? Like, people are here and then they're like, oh, what Kardashian would you marry? My mum. Oh, darling, how are you? How are you feeling? How's your leg? Broken, mum. That's how my leg is. Excuse me. I'd have to send 5,000 emails. But you know what I mean? Imagine small talk for like 3 hours. Oh, and I even got angry with Ty, which I feel really bad about. I know that he's just trying to help, but he's trying to help in a boy way. He's trying to track down the guy that we think might, for legal reasons, might be responsible. And like making sure that he's punished. He's just so fixated on it. It's like Sherlock. And I know he's trying to help, but I snapped at him and I feel bad. And then he gave me this. Clementine 2.0, because we couldn't get the real one in here. And I remember that he was all right. Sure, he's a doofus, but he's my doofus. That's why he gets numbers 9 to 13, because Tyler is so much more than one reason. Anyway, guys, so that's all 13 reasons why being stuck in this hospital bed ain't so bad. Bye, guys. No, I googled one. Sebogum. 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 Sebogum.